Welcome to the session of e-NISCHIT, the HIV-TB initiative for learning from each other, case-based learning. You learn from us, we learn from you. And I welcome the centers of UP and Delhi today. I can see there is a very, very good attendance of Delhi and UP today. Plus, we also have some of our friends joining in from South India, Andhra and Tamil Nadu, who did have this session last week, but I guess they would wanted to do it again because this is actually a very important session. Before I move on to the agenda, let me introduce my team. I am Dr. Upasna. I work as the head of Department of Medicine as in charge of ART at the National Institute of TB and Respiratory Diseases. On my right is Dr. Vandana. Dr. Vandana is currently the project director for the e-NISCHIT activity at Share India. But before that, she has had a lot of program experience because she was a deputy director of our SACS. So she has a vast experience in the topic that she's going to take today. Then we have on my left, we have Ajit, who provides the logistics and is the relationship manager for this clinic from Share India. So with this, let me now move to the agenda. So today, first we will have a didactic by Dr. Vandana Dabla, and she will talk on recording and reporting of HIV-TB data in the ART centers. And we will actually begin, this time we don't have a case because this session itself is a very big session. And before I move on to the poll for attendance, the only thing I want to ask you people is that please understand this is a very, very important session. Documentation is a very, very important part of a program activity. Actually, it is a very important program of any patient care activity. Kabhi-kabhi hum aisa sochte hain ki hum to mareez dekh lete hain to bas bahut hai, ab likhne ki kya zarurat hai. Par aisa nahi hai. Agar hum apna kiya hua kaam document nahi karte hain, to kahin na kahin kuch chhoot jata hai, lapses ho jate hain. Aur kabhi-kabhi aisa hota hai ki humko course correction bhi karna padta hai. Hum kuch kare ja rahe hote hain, not as an individual, but even as a program. Program level pe kuch kare ja rahe hote hain, aur wo itna effective nahi hota jitna humne socha hota hai. To agar hamare paas uska data nahi hota, agar theek se reported nahi hota, agar data ki monitoring nahi hoti, recording nahi hoti, to hum apni galti ko sudhar nahi sakte. Aur jo hamara basic aim hai ki hum is country mein HIV aur TB ka burden kam karna chahte hain, marizon ko treat karna chahte hain, wo us cheez ko hum achieve nahi kar sakte. To agar aaj ke session se agar aap se mujhe meri ek hi request hai ki please dhyan se sune, jahan samajh na aaye please apne questions poochein, bahut important session hai, aur kabhi bhi ye na sochein ki recording and reporting important nahi hai. Please understand documentation utna hi important hai jitna patient dekhna important hai. So now we will move on for the poll of attendance. Please attendance laga dijiye apni. 2 minute ke liye poll hai. Just another 10 seconds for attendance poll, please. Please complete your poll. So okay, now we will move on to the pretest. Is pretest mein kuch aise questions hain jo aaj ke topic se related hain. अभी जो आपको लगता है सही आंसर है आप दीजिए और लेट्स सी व्हाट इट कि वो सही था कि नहीं था या आपने आज सेशन से कुछ और नया सीखा वो देखेंगे. चलिए तो अब वी शुड गो ऑन टू द प्रीटेस्ट. अनदर 30 सेकंड्स फॉर द प्रीटेस्ट. आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीबॉडी टू कंप्लीट द प्रीटेस्ट एट द अर्लीस्ट. एंड नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर वंदना डबला टू प्लीज डिलीवर हर डिडैक्टिक.
या थैंक यू मैम. थैंक्स अ लॉट. And good afternoon, everyone. So today we are going to see the recording and reporting tools for HIV-TB. As we have just discussed that if recording is not done or reporting is not done, that means the work is not done, right? So if we are not going to report and record, अगर हमने अपना काम को record नहीं किया कि हमने क्या किया है, इसका मतलब हमने अपना काम किया ही नहीं. और ये हम बहुत अच्छे तरीके से जानते हैं अपने system में. So recording and reporting is extremely important. So here, starting with the presentation. So by the end of presentation, we will be able to know the management of TB in pale HIV at ART center in terms of recording and reporting. And then how are we going to write the IPT things in the recording and reporting format for NAPO. Now, why recording and reporting is important? because one, it ensures the high quality patient care. So if we know ki hamare paas patient ki information kya hai, uska CB net kya hai, uska wo kaun sa type ke TB jo hai usko infection hai, to tabhi hum patient ki quality care kar payenge. Agar hame yahi nahi pata ki patient ka infection kaun sa hai, uska CB net result kya hai, uske x-ray ke findings kya hai, we won't be able to give the quality care to patient. And plus, it is also important recording and reporting for the transfer of information. Suppose that the patient was taking treatment in one ART center and then in between transfer to other ART center, which happens a lot, right, in our settings, because patient moved from even one state to the other. We forget about even one ART center to the other. Ek state se dusre state mein bhi jaate hain. Wahan pe, if we do not record and report the correct HIV and TB information into the register, into the white card and green book, then this transfer of information will not be correctly transferred to the other center. Then the other thing is, again, as I said, that it is important for the high quality patient care to provide and adequate services. Then how do we monitor the program? Again, because of correct recording and reporting. If we know that, you know, as per the data, we are able to monitor the patient records, right, and the entire program. Plus, this monitoring and reporting policy is only helpful for the basis and development of the programmatic and policy development. हम जब ये देखते हैं कि हमारा CD4 result ऐसा आ रहा है, patient को ये infection है, या फिर इस particular medicine से ये particular side effects हो रहे हैं, हम regularly उसको report करते हैं, record करते हैं, वहीं से हमारे national level पे जो है policy में और program में change आता है. अगर हम वो चीजें ढंग से रिकॉर्ड नहीं करेंगे, if we are not recording these things properly, then it is very difficult that at a state level or at a national level, we are able to change the policy or modify the policy in a patient-centric way. Then of course, the correct data of recording and reporting helps in the effective supervision. So unless you have recorded the correct information about patient, that how many patients are there in the ART center who are infected with HIV-TB, how would we monitor and supervise, right? So it is, again, is it effective for effective supervision and monitoring? So in today's didactic, we are going to see the different recording and reporting tools, right? NACT formats, example, patient visit register, green book, white card, HIV-TB line list, HIV-TB register, master line list, and the HIV-TB monthly report. And these are the RNTCP formats which we are going to discuss, which include the lab referral form, TB treatment card, ID card, DRTB referral form, and of course the NITRD software. Now, the care coordinator is the first point of contact for any patient who visits the ART center. जब भी कोई मरीज आएगा, वो सबसे पहले care coordinator के पास जाता है, हमें पता है। और यहाँ पे care coordinator maintain करता है एक patient visit register को, जहाँ पे वो उसका नाम, serial number, उसका registration number जो है नोट करता है. So now this is the first time when the care coordinator check for 4S symptom in the patient. We know all the 4S symptom, that is fever, cough of any duration, weight loss and the night sweat. So here it is the responsibility of care coordinator कि जब patient आए तो सबसे पहले वो ये चार symptoms जो हैं उसमें देखे और वहाँ पे अपने patient visit register में उसे नोट करे. If he finds that one symptom or more than one symptoms are present, then a red color 4S positive stem has to be put in this column number 3 in the 4S symptom. And if he finds or she finds that there is no symptom and patient is 4S negative, koi symptom nahi hai, to wahan pe wo blue color ki 4S negative ki stamp lagayega. Minor same stamp wo patient visit register ke alawa green card mein bhi lagayega. Now, green card ke section mein, ye wala humara naya green card hai, isme already printed hai ye version. Purane wale green cards mein, jinke paas mein stationery purani hogi, kuch ART centers mein, we know ki wahan pe ye sections jo the 4S symptom ke nahi the, to unke paas mein ek detailed stamp hoga. Right? So, now here in the green book, it is the responsibility of the staff nurse to screen further patient for 4S symptoms. तो एक बार अगर वो 4S पॉजिटिव है, अगर केयर कोऑर्डिनेटर कहता है स्टैंप में लगा दी कि 4S पॉजिटिव है, अगेन स्टाफ नर्स जो है उसको वैलिडेट करेगी थोड़े सिम्टम के लिए कि क्या उसमें ये चारों सिम्टम्स हैं, कोई एक सिम्टम या कोई भी एक सिम्टम है, एंड इफ एनी वन ऑफ द सिम्टम इज प्रेजेंट शी इज गोइंग टू टिक ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर सिम्टम, राइट, आइदर कफ और वेट लॉस, फीवर, नाइट स्वेट. Now, if the patient is child, then in case of children, the option of night sweat will be replaced with the contact of active TB case. Agar bachcha hai, to agar uske ghar mein koi bhi active TB case hai, ya fir agar uske neighborhood mein jahan pe bachcha bahut zyada jata hai, okay, yahan pe immediate family ki bhi baat kar rahe hain aur hum unki bhi baat kar rahe hain jinke saath wo bachcha zyada tar rehta hai. To agar wahan pe bhi unko TB hai, to hum isko positive manenge ki yes, the child is with the contact of active TB. तो वहाँ पे बच्चों के केस में हम night sweat की जगह ये contact of active TB रखेंगे. तो इस तरीके से staff nurse will further screen all patients referred by care coordinator and validate the symptoms and record the findings in the patient green book using the details tab. अगर कोई है तो वो tick लगाएंगी और अगर नहीं है तो वो cross लगाएंगी इस तरीके से. Now you can see on the screen a big cross on all the four symptoms which talks about 4S negative. Like no symptom is present, no, not even one of the symptoms is present. Now going further, now this is a white card where again medical officer at the level of MO and at the level of SMO, again the 4S symptom screening is being done and that has been recorded in this section, that is 13A. So first, humne dekha ki first the patient was screened at the level of care coordinator when he enters, then he screened at the level of स्टाफ नर्स अगर वो पॉजिटिव आया है और उसके बाद में सीधा वो एमओ के पास आता है, वहां पे भी उसकी थर्ड टाइम स्क्रीनिंग होती है. और यहाँ पे अगर एमओ को लगता है कि वो 4S सिम्टम उसमें है तो वो यहाँ पे 4S सिम्टम पॉजिटिव लिखेंगे और या फिर अगर नेगेटिव है तो नेगेटिव लिखेंगे. एंड देन इन द सेक्शन नंबर 9 ऑफ सेक्शन 13, द कॉलम नंबर 9 ऑफ सेक्शन 13, द आईपीटी स्टेटस इज ऑल्सो रिटन. नाउ आईपीटी स्टेटस के लिए, now if it is not applicable means the patient is a TB patient, patient is on TB drugs, so of course we cannot put patient on IPT, so we write the not applicable. So here only NA would come. We will use only short form, hum short form use karenge. If the patient is initiated on IPT during first visit, we will write IPT 1. If the patient is having contraindication towards IPT, the medical officer is going to write CONT, the short form. And if the patient is on IPT, so for every visit, the MO is right and patient is on IPT and patient is visiting every time. So he has to write IPT, simple. And if IPT is stopped due to any medical reason or other reason, then ST has to be written in this column. Then we can see here the section number 14. Here the TB regimen status, that means the TB treatment status is to be written. Over here, for example, it is not applicable. Not applicable means the patient is not having TB, that is NA, or initiated on ATT this month, ATT1, or if the patient is on ATT, patient dawai kha raha hai TB ki, then simple we write ATT, or agar humne ATT stop kar di hai due to any reason, we write ST, or agar humara ATT ka jo course hai pura kar liya hai patient ne, we will write POMP, that means treatment completed, that's it. So now this has to be done by the medical officer. Now, we all know this is the first page of the white card. That is the patient treatment record, which is kept at the ART center. And here, the result of investigations are to be recorded in section 12. Now section 12 is this investigation part, right? So we'll come on this slide. This is just to show you that this is section number 12, where the investigation results are being written. And then the SMO will interpret the report and clinical investigation and establish a diagnosis of TB. The diagnosis should be recorded in the white card under section 7. So this is the section 7 where the medical officer will write and put a stamp also and sign. So based on the clinical findings and investigations, the patients will be categorized here as PTBM or pulmonary TB, that is microbiologically confirmed. We'll see in the next slides what does these mean. Okay, we will see the full definition of all these things. So we have to write the SMO or MO is going to write the status of this, right, the category of the TB disease, and if the rifampicin resistance is there or the patient is sensitive or status not known, then This is all to be mentioned. And the past history of TB also be recorded. And then all relevant details should be entered in this column number 7. Now, this is the investigation section where we have to write the CBNAT result. So this is meant to record the CBNAT values. And we can also see that there is a section where we can also write about the findings of the X-rays. So here we have to write the findings of the X-ray, or even if we have sent the patient for ultrasound, right? And suppose if we have sent the patient for other investigation apart from CBNAT, that is sputum culture, then we have this column of others. So we will specify that we have sent the patient for culture and we will write the report over here with date and findings. Now, let us see the RNTCP formats and tools used in the ART centers. And before going that, it is very important to look at the definitions. So now these definitions we have earlier in many occasions have had the chance of, you know, going through these definitions. Again, we'll have a look of it. Now, first is microbiologically confirmed TB case. Now, this is that TB case jahan pe aapka biological jo patient ka specimen hai, that comes positive for acid fast bacilli or is positive for mycobacterium tuberculosis on culture or through quality assured rapid diagnostic molecular test. For example, jo CBNAT test hai, agar wo hota hai, या फिर कल्चर के लिए भेजते हैं, स्पूटम कल्चर के लिए आपने टेस्टिंग के लिए भेजा है, या फिर बायोप्सी के लिए भेजा है पेशेंट को बायोप्सी टेस्ट, तो वो सारे के सारे जो है वहां पे अगर कंफर्म्ड होता है पेशेंट, तो वो माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकली कंफर्म टीबी केस में गिना जाएगा, उसमें आएगा. नाउ व्हाट इज क्लिनिकली डायग्नोस टीबी केस. नाउ क्लिनिकली डायग्नोस टीबी केस वो केसेस होते हैं जहां पे वी आर नॉट एबल टू कंफर्म द टीबी डायग्नोसिस थ्रू माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकली, राइट और उसमें हमें लगता है कि पेशेंट डिटीरियोरेट कर रहा है, लेकिन सीबीनेट, एग्जांपल सीबीनेट नेगेटिव है, लेकिन आपको लगता है कि फ्लोरोसेंटम पॉजिटिव है और एक्सरे की फाइंडिंग भी पॉजिटिव है, तो ऐसे केसेस जो हैं वो आपके क्लिनिकली डायग्नोस्ड टीबी केस बनते हैं. सो टीबी पेशेंट हु इज नॉट माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकली कंफर्म्ड बट हैज बीन क्लिनिकली डायग्नोस्ड विद एक्टिव टीबी बाय क्लिनिशियन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रेडियोलॉजिकल एबनॉर्मलिटीज और क्लिनिकल साइंस with a decision to treat the patient with a full course of ATT. Now comes the pulmonary TB. As the nomenclature suggests, the TB which happens in the pulmonary part, that is involving the lung parenchyma or tracheobronchial tree, comes under the pulmonary TB. And anything other than that comes under the extrapulmonary TB. So any microbiologically confirmed or clinically diagnosed case of tuberculosis involving organs other than lungs. So it can be pleura, it can involve lymph nodes, it can be TB of intestine, joints, bone. We can have, example, we have meningeal TB cases. So all these fall under the category of extrapulmonary tuberculosis. Now suppose that the patient is having both type of TB, right? The patient is having the infection in the lungs as well, and the patient's lymph nodes are also infected. So in these cases, we will categorize patient as having the pulmonary TB. हम ऐसे में दोनों नहीं लिखेंगे, ऐसे में हम उसको यहाँ पे देखें नीचे स्लाइड्स में, यू कैन सी वी हैव टू राइट अबाउट पीटीबी. ओके, वी कैटेगराइज पेशेंट एज पल्मोनरी टीबी इवन इफ द पेशेंट इज हैविंग, इन केस इफ द पेशेंट इज हैविंग बोथ द टाइप ऑफ टीबी. नाउ लेट्स सी द टाइप ऑफ टीबी पेशेंट्स. सो द फर्स्ट इज द न्यू टीबी पेशेंट्स. So any TB patient who has never had treatment for TB or has taken anti-TB drugs for less than 1 month is considered as a new case. So या तो पहली बार उसको TB हुआ है, ART center आया है, तो इस category में आएगा. या फिर अगर पहले भी TB उसको हुआ है, लेकिन उसने एक महीने से कम दवाई ली है, for less than 1 month if the patient has taken, सिर्फ उसने 20 दिन दवाई खाई, 20 days के लिए दवाई खाई, तो the patient still be counted as new patient, right? Now, who is the previously treated? Previously treated patient is a patient who was infected with tuberculosis earlier and had received a medication anti-TB treatment for 1 month or more. मतलब अगर उसने 1 month and 10 days भी दवाई खा ली है पहले, तो हम उसको previously treated में count करेंगे. Now, there are further classification for this previously treated. As we can see, there are four classification. One is the recurrent one, as the name suggests. उसको recurrent बार बार हो रहा है. So a TB patient declared as successfully treated, example cured or treatment completed, is as a subsequently found to be microbiologically confirmed TB case. हमने कहा कि पहले वो उसका treatment complete हो चुका है, लेकिन उसके बाद भी जो है microbiologically वो TB confirm हो गया उसको, तो हम कहेंगे उसको recurrent infection हो गया है, तो उसको इस category में डालेंगे. Now treatment after failure, as a, again as the name suggests, मतलब पहले उसका TB का जो treatment है वो जो है वो fail हो गया. That means a TB patient who has previously been treated for TB and his treatment failed at the end of their most recent course of action. Now this is treatment after LFU. That means the TB patient previously treated for TB for 1 month or more, उसने एक महीना या उससे ज़्यादा दवाई खाई और उसके बाद में the patient is lost to follow. Patient has not returned to ART center for TB treatment. So now, ऐसे cases में हम उसको treatment after LFU कहेंगे. Now we have to keep in our mind that when we talk about TB treatment, the LFU is 1 month, and when we talk about ART treatment, okay, the LFU is 3 months. So in many ART cases, we have seen that patient is coming regularly to ART center. Co-infected patient, HIV-TB है उसको, the patient is coming to ART center for ARV drugs, but patient is against taking the ATT. He doesn't want to take the ATT, right? तो वो ऐसे, now in such cases, patient is having good adherence on ART, but if the patient has left, you know, taking the NTTB treatment for more than a month, then the patient is classified as LFU for TB treatment. So here, the patient is adherent, having good adherence on ARV. For HIV treatment part, the patient is not LFU, taking the ARV, but for anti-TB drugs, the patient is LFU. Now, other previously treated is all the other patients, the TB patients who have been previously treated for TB, but whose outcome after their most recent course of treatment is unknown or documented. That means, वहाँ पे recording or reporting ठीक नहीं हुई है. The patient was a TB patient, the patient had taken medicine, and but क्या हुआ, patient ने कितनी दिन दवाई ली, last में उसका क्या हुआ, treatment complete हुआ नहीं हुआ, हमने record नहीं कर पाए, या फिर patient, मतलब patient के पास कोई record नहीं है, ART के पास कोई record नहीं है, तो ऐसे patient को other previously treated patient में हम category में रखेंगे. Transferred in, again it's very simple, any patient, TB patient who is received for treatment in a TB unit after registering for TB treatment in another unit. एक ART center जो है, एक ART में वो दवाई खा रहा था TB की, after 1 month the patient wants to go to other ART center because of some reason, because he has changed the house or residence and changed the ART maybe, then we call the patient as transferred. Now this is very interesting slide. It is talk about treatment outcomes. And the interesting thing is about the difference between a cured patient and a treatment completed patient. Because many a times we say that treatment completed is means treatment cured. Agar humne, अगर पेशेंट ने पूरा ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीट कर लिया है तो पेशेंट क्योर हो गया, ऐसा नहीं. हम पेशेंट जो हम कहेंगे कि क्योर है, वहां पे जहां पे माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकली कंफर्म टीबी पेशेंट्स एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट हु वाज स्मियर और कल्चर नेगेटिव एट द एंड ऑफ द कंप्लीट ट्रीटमेंट. सो क्योर मीन्स वी हैव एन एविडेंस, हमारे पास एक एविडेंस है ये बताने के लिए कि पेशेंट जो है अब उसमें जो है वो बैक्टीरिया जो है वो नहीं है. सो दैट कम्स अंडर द क्योर पार्ट. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीटेड? ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीटेड इज दैट पेशेंट वाज रेगुलरली ऑन एंटी टीबी ड्रग और उसने जो है अपनी ड्रग पूरा जो उसका कोर्स था, चाहे 6 महीने का या 8 मंथ्स का, दैट ही हैज कंप्लीटेड एंड नाउ जो है पेशेंट इज नॉट हैविंग एनी साइन एंड सिम्टम ऑफ टीबी, राइट? सो एनी टीबी पेशेंट हु कंप्लीटेड ट्रीटमेंट विदाउट एविडेंस ऑफ फेलियर और क्लिनिकल डिटेरियोरेशन, मतलब आपको पेशेंट हेल्दी लग रहा है, उसमें कोई क्लिनिकली डिटेरियोरेशन नहीं है, बट विद नो रिपोर्ट टू शो दैट द स्मियर और कल्चर रिजल्ट्स ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल स्पेसिमेन इन द लास्ट मंथ ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट वॉज नेगेटिव, आइदर बिकॉज टेस्ट वॉज नॉट डन और बिकॉज रिजल्ट इज अनअवेलेबल, दैट कम्स एंड दैट फॉल्स अंडर द ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीटेड. ओके, सो हियर आई गिव यू अ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल दैट when we keep a category, we put the patient in a category of this. Look at this, clinically diagnosed patient, right? So, जहां पे आपने ट्रीटमेंट शुरू किया उसके क्लिनिकल साइन एंड सिम्टम को देखिए. सीबी नेट नेगेटिव था लेकिन जो है मेडिकल ऑफिसर को लगा कि पेशेंट को टीबी हो सकता है और पेशेंट ने जो है क्लिनिकली डायग्नोस्ड केस में उसको आइडेंटिफाई किया और वहां पे हमने उसकी एटीटी शुरू कर दी. सो नाउ आफ्टर द कोर्स 6 महीने बाद पेशेंट बिल्कुल ठीक है, पेशेंट को कोई साइन एंड सिम्टम नहीं है, तो वहां पे हम लोग उसको ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीटेड की कैटेगरी में रखेंगे. क्योंकि यहाँ पे अगेन हमारे पास स्मियर या कल्चर नहीं है, राइट, पर हमें पता है कि पेशेंट जो है क्लिनिकली इंप्रूव्ड है, तो यहाँ पे हम उसको ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीटेड की कैटेगरी में रखेंगे. एंड वी मस्ट नो दैट आइदर द पेशेंट इज क्योर्ड और द ट्रीटमेंट इज कंप्लीटेड, वी कॉल इट एज द ट्रीटमेंट सक्सेस. दैट मींस हमारा ट्रीटमेंट सक्सेसफुल है, राइट. सो पेशेंट टीबी पेशेंट आइदर क्योर्ड और ट्रीटमेंट कंप्लीटेड आर अकाउंटेड इन ट्रीटमेंट सक्सेस. And failure treatment. Failure is a TB patient whose biological specimen is positive by smear or culture at the end of the treatment. That means patient has, you know, there is a failure to respond to the anti-tubercular treatment and drugs. Now, loss to follow up, we have already discussed in HIV-TB clients and TB, for specifically for ATT, we know that TB patient whose treatment was interrupted for one consecutive month or more, it is called LFU, right? Again, I repeat, for ART, LFU is 3 months, for TB, it is for 1. So it may happen that patient is regular for ART, but is irregular for TB, right? So aap ye nahi keh sakte ki wo patient jo hai wo pura hi LFU ho gaya. वो ART की अगर दवाई खा रहा है लेकिन टीबी की दवाई नहीं खा रहा तो हम उसको ART में adherent मानेंगे लेकिन टीबी में हम LFU रिकॉर्ड करेंगे. नॉट evaluated द टीबी पेशेंट फॉर whom नो ट्रीटमेंट आउटकम इज assigned. सो दिस includes former ट्रांसफर out. सो दिस इज नॉट evaluated. जहां पे हमने उसका कोई जो ट्रीटमेंट का आउटकम है लिखा ही नहीं है. शायद ये हो सकता है तब जब हमारी रिकॉर्डिंग में भी मिस्टेक हो सकती है या फिर हमारे पास कुछ है ही नहीं, वहां पे इट इज नॉट इवैल्यूएटेड. चेंज व्हेन द रेजिमेन ऑफ द ट्रीटमेंट इज चेंज्ड, सो वी पुट इट एज ट्रीटमेंट रेजिमेन. फॉर एग्जांपल द पेशेंट वाज ऑन फर्स्ट लाइन रेजिमेन एंड नाउ द पेशेंट जो है वो हमें लगा पता चला कि द पेशेंट इज हैविंग डीआरटीबी एंड वी स्विच द ड्रग यू नो अगेन टू द ड्रग रेजिस्टेंट टीबी रेजिमेन. सो दैट इज डिक्लेयर्ड एज ट्रीटमेंट रेजिमेन चेंज. And last, the diet, that is the treatment outcome, means the patient who has died during the course of anti-TB treatment. So now, okay. So here, the RNTCP request form for examination of biological specimen for TB. So it shall be used. For requesting diagnosis of TB and DRTB by ART center. So now this RNTCP request form to be filled by RNTCP. And then TMC and CBNet LT performs the test and reports the result along with Nikshay ID to ART center on daily basis. And these forms will be provided by RNTCP to all ART centers. Now this is the format for the RNTCP form, we can see. And it's to be used for CBNet testing. Right? Now, this is the second part to be filled by the lab to report the results and need to be sent to ART center. So, this page, the first page is to be filled by the ART center where all the patient information and referring facility, why you are sending patient for testing. So, all these and exactly the test requested, but exactly what test you want to have, that is CBNAT, you need to write. So, that this is ART center's responsibility and this is the responsibility of the RNTCP that the RNTCP will give you the result. Now this is the case sample one, okay, where this is we have pre-filled RNTCP request form for you to have a look, where we write the patient name, clearly the mobile number, patient address, age, HIV status and all these part and the name of the referring facility, which is very, very important that we have to click. Right, and all the information regarding, and see we have written like predominant symptoms, right, why we are sending patients. So it is a case of presumptive TB here we are saying. This is a case sample 2 for diagnosis and follow-up of drug resistant TB, where all the information about the medical doctor, see, and the email ID and contact number has been written. again, this is a format which we can see, the case template, where the reports of culture and all has to be written. Microscopy has to be documented. Either it is detected or not detected, whether rifampicin resistance is present, not present, the date of test, very important, and date reported and quoted by. The person will sign the report as well. Now, this slide is, you have seen in many previous presentations, which talks about the integrated drug resistance TB algorithm, and it shows that CBNAT is very, very important and has to be done for every suspected HIV-TB patient. Now, let's talk about the TB treatment card. So this is the TB treatment card, which is the page one. Okay. So TB treatment card should be filled by the staff nurse in duplicate, and one copy is to be given to patient along with TB ID card, and the other is maintained at the ART center. Again, we have to fill all the requested information about the patient, the site of disease, everything, and HIV related information. So all documentation has to be completed for the patient. Now this is the page two of the TB treatment card. So here, the weight, height, and everything has to be recorded. The weight band has to be recorded here. Okay, and then the follow-up also. The post-treatment follow-up, clinical and sputum, along with the results, has to be mentioned in this column. Now, this is the TB ID card, where again, all the information about the patient has to be registered, and this card is kept with the patient. Now, this is the DRTB referral form. So, all the rifampicin resistant TB cases shall be referred to the DTO, that is the district TB officer, by the ART center. So, all patient details need to be filled out completely. Now, this we all know, NITRD. Now, we must know that we were previously entering all the patient report into 99 dots. Hum log 99 dots mein karte the, lekin ab jo hai, wo 99 dots jo hai, wo NITRD mein, ke site mein jo hai, wo merge ho gaya hai. Aur isi site pe jo hai, hum uski patient ki entry karte hain. We will have a complete discussion on NITRD, and on this platform only, we will discuss in detail about these entries. This is just to show you and have you a look that ऑनलाइन ऑल्सो हम जो है ये मेंटेन करते हैं, और ये एआरटी सेंटर की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि वो पेशेंट का डेटा जो है वो NITRD पोर्टल पे मेंटेन करे. दिस इज जस्ट अ ग्लिम्स. सो नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द रिवाइज्ड एचआईवी टीबी टूल. सो दिस इज इंटरेस्टिंग. नाउ फर्स्ट इज द एचआईवी टीबी लाइन लिस्ट. इट्स अ लॉन्ग लाइन लिस्ट वी नो. सो दिस इज ओनली द लेफ्ट हाफ ऑफ इट. सिर्फ एक हिस्सा अभी हमें दिखाई दे रहा है, एंड दिस इज द अदर हाफ. Right, so we are having 20 columns. So let's talk about the first 12 columns. Right, so we have to, you know, we have to write the serial number, date, registration number, name, age, sex, contact number, and address. Now here I want to specify, please, again and again, whenever we are going to fill this line list, please validate address whenever patient comes, you know, again and again. Why? Because maybe in our previous books the address is different, and here if we feel ke hame address to pata hi hai, hamara purana patient hai, humne usko suspect kiya hai TB ke liye, to purana address hi hum dal denge. Nahi ho sakta hai patient ne address change kiya ho. So we need to ask the new address of the patient. Now, who all comes in the HIV TB line list? So the patients who are, to whom we have suspicions that these are the patients who might have TB, hame lagta hai ki jahan pe is patient ko TB ho sakta hai, wo sare patients jo hain wo HIV TB line list mein aayenge. राइट, जिनको हम टेस्टिंग के लिए भेज रहे हैं. तो यहाँ पे जो हमें लगता है फोर सिम्टम जिनके पॉजिटिव हैं, जिनको हमें या फिर क्लिनिकली हमें लगता है कि वो डिटीरियोरेट कर रहे हैं और उनको टीबी हो सकता है, तो वो सारे जो पेशेंट्स हैं उनकी लिस्ट यहाँ पे आएगी. राइट, तो एच आई वी टीबी लाइन लिस्ट एंड इज टू बी मेंटेन्ड बाय स्टाफ नर्स. तो दो चीजें इंपॉर्टेंट है. वन इज दिस लिस्ट इज to be filled by staff nurse. Second thing, all the presumptive cases of TB जिसको हम verify करने के लिए भेज रहे हैं, वो सारे के सारे HIV TB line list में आएंगे. So here we have to write the status at the time of TB referral, right? Patient is already on ART or not. Then the type of facility where the patient is referred. For example, here, see, in the note, we have to write either A, B, C. That means either we are sending patient to DMC or we are sending patient for CVNAT. If we are sending patient for CVNAT, we just have to write B. Or if we are sending patient for X-ray for any radiological investigation, we will write C. Or if we are sending patient for biopsy for any histopathology, we will write D. Right? Or any other investigation, we have to write E. Then type of test, again, we have to write either A for CVNAT, B for smear, C for culture, or D for TST for children under 5 years of age. Right? So it has to be filled like that in column number 12. We have to write if the patient diagnosed with TB or not. Now this column is to be filled only when we will receive the reports, okay, investigation reports. Now coming to the other side of the HIV-TB line list, so we have to write the drug resistance status. Again, column number 12 and column number 13 are to be filled only when we receive the result of the investigation, and again the type of TB diagnosed. That's also filled only after once we receive the investigation results. So here in the type of TB, if diagnosed with TB, see it is clearly written. So all these columns are to be filled. Type of TB diagnosed. So here we can pick the relevant code. For example, we can write one. Okay, we can just write run one if it is a pulmonary TB, which is microbiologically confirmed. We have just seen and discussed it in a very detailed way. What do you mean by this? Or we've just put a second number, that is for pulmonary TB clinically diagnosed, or for EPTB, which is microbiologically confirmed, or phone number for extra pulmonary TB clinically diagnosed. Now, in case of invalid, error, or no result, or intermediate result, wait for final diagnosis and update the status as and when the result become available. So, jaise hi hamare paas result aata hai, hame waise hi usme note karna hai, right? So, here, date of TB diagnosis, mixture ID, date of starting ATT, and if diagnosed with DRTB, then we have to write all these information, right? So, here, it is important for the date of referral to DRTB center, name of DRTB center referred for treatment, and date of starting DRTB. So now this was regarding the HIV-TB line list. Now, once we are confirmed that patient is having tubercular infection, then all those patients are to be documented, the information has to be documented into HIV-TB register. So this is confirmed TB cases. Ek baar hame pata chal gaya, hamare paas document ho gaya ki हमारे मरीज को टीबी है तो वो सारे मरीज की इंफॉर्मेशन एचआईवी टीबी रजिस्टर में आनी चाहिए. नाउ इन एचआईवी टीबी रजिस्टर्स ऑल दोस पेशेंट्स आल्सो कम्स फॉर हु आर डायरेक्टली रेफर्ड टू द एआरटी सेंटर एंड आर ऑलरेडी डायग्नोस्ड विद टीबी. आरएनटीसीपी में पेशेंट है, ऑलरेडी टीबी की मेडिसिन ले रहा है, और देन द पेशेंट इज सेंट टू एआरटी सेंटर, देन वी डोंट हैव टू send patient for confirmation, then the HIV-TB line list mein wo nahi aayega. The patient will not come under HIV-TB line list because we already know the status of the patient, right? That patient directly comes in the HIV-TB register because it is already the confirmed TB case, right? So all the confirmed TB cases either we have sent or we are being sent, ya to hume humare paas bheje gaya ya humne pata lagaya hai, wo sare ke sare register mein aayenge. Let's see, we have to write it very clearly. Date, HIV, registration number, name, age, sex, contact number. Again, I'm telling in every visit, please ask about the contact number. Patient jo hai, wo change kar sakta hai apna phone number, right? So address ko hume bar bar validate karna hai because this will come in handy. Jab patient jo LFE ho jata hai, hume pata hi nahi hota patient address change kar gaya. Usne 4 mahine pehle address change kar gaya aur humne yahan pe jo hai update hi nahi kiya tha. To यहाँ पे हमारी रिकॉर्डिंग और रिपोर्टिंग काम आती है, यहाँ पे रिकॉर्डिंग काम आती है. Then comes from where the patient has been referred, right? So यहाँ पे देखें, we can see here whether the patient is referred by ART center for TB diagnosis or referred by ICTC. So we have to write accordingly, okay? A or B, or if the patient is already a known case of TB referred by RNTCP to ICTC, in that case we have to write C. Or the patient was referred from the private practitioner. So accordingly, we will write the alphabets A, B, C, D. Then we have to write the status of drug resistance, the type of TB diagnosed, right? From here, the relevant code, again, we have seen it. We will write the type of TB diagnosed, the date of TB diagnosis, and of course, the next year. Now the other part of the HIV-TB register, बहुत लंबा register होता है हमारा, होना भी चाहिए क्योंकि इतनी सारी recordings हैं हमारे पास में उसमें, बहुत चीजें हमें record करनी पड़ती हैं. So we will write the type of patient over here. Type of patient means we just discussed whether the patient is a new patient. Remember, patient may नया patient है पहली बार हुआ है या फिर एक महीने से कम दवाई खाई है, less than 1 month comes under new or recurrent or treatment after LSU. So we'll write all these. So this information in the column number 14. Then date of starting ATT, very clearly we have to mention, this is important. Then if not initiated on ATT, reason for the same. So here we can find, you can see the reason. Patient transferred out to other ART center, is which is a shuru nahi kar paaye, we have to write A. Or patient not reporting to treatment, patient is LFU, so we have to write LFU or B, right? So we have to specify very clearly the reason for which the ATT is not started or patient died. And then, hence, if we go further, then name and type of facility from where the patient is receiving TB treatment, that is to be mentioned very clearly. Okay, that we can see here. कहाँ से वो दवाई ले रहा है? ART center से या RNTP से, RNTCP से? Or patient has declared that I don't want to continue ATT from ART center, I will take it from private institution. So whatever it is, it has to be recorded properly. Type of TB treatment. Now here we know that in newer regimen we don't have category 2, it is either 1, 4, or 5. So the patient will, so you have to write accordingly. Date of treatment completion has to be written. Treatment outcome, we just discussed what could be the treatment outcomes, that is cure, treatment completed, died, failure, LFU, transfer out or switched over or other. Then is the patient on CPT, we have just have to write yes or no. Date of ART initiation, registration number, if not initiated on ART, again the reason. So that we have to write here. We can pick the reasons, like we just have to write A, B, C, D accordingly. Now let's have this case scenario, right? Suppose if the patient is taking TB drugs for past 2 months and now detected HIV positive at ICTC.
Vandana, can I just interrupt you?
Yeah, sure.
I can see a lot of restless activity. We are actually at the end of the talk. This was an important talk. And I would request all of you to please now focus on the case scenario so that we could have a more interactive session.
Please. Yes. Thanks, ma'am. I think this is the icebreaker, the case scenario. That is, a patient is taking the TB drugs for past 2 months. Pichle 2 mahine se wo TB ki dawai kha raha hai. और अभी अचानक से उसको HIV पॉजिटिव जो है, HIV इन्फेक्शन डिटेक्ट हो गया ICTC में, राइट? पेशेंट को ICTC ने ART सेंटर भेज दिया. सो नाउ इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रिपोर्ट्स दिस पेशेंट्स एंट्री शुड बी डॉक्यूमेंटेड. आपको क्या लगता है, व्हाट डू यू फील, इन विच रिकॉर्ड शुड द पेशेंट बी एंटर्ड? द पेशेंट विल बी एंटर्ड इन लाइन लिस्ट, और द पेशेंट विल बी एंटर्ड इन रजिस्टर, और इन बोथ, और शुड नॉट बी एंटर्ड इनटू HIV-TB रजिस्टर?
Any volunteers, please? Please, would somebody like to tell what is their thoughts on this?
In chat, a lot of answers we are receiving. That is, many are saying it is B, HIV-TB register. We have also a C option, that is both. Thank God nobody is saying D. It is fine, it is good that nobody is saying D.
So, okay. So, why do you think it should also go into the HIV-TB line list? See, this person is already a diagnosed case of TB. Right. He is not a suspected TB case or presumptive TB case who is sent out for investigations from the ART center. This is somebody who is already on TB treatment, has come to you while on TB treatment. So this person goes only in the HIV-TB register.
Right. So correct answer is B, because the patient is already a TB diagnosed patient. That was also a good icebreaker, the case scenario. So now we move further. So we can see this is HIV-TB notification register, where only confirmed TB cases are to be mentioned. And again, all the specified information, asked information, has to be documented completely and very clearly. Now, these are the other parts of the HIV-TB notification register. So again, we have to spell out everything clearly. That is result of the test and everything, diabetic status, and every part of it has to be documented. Yeah. You can see this is the post-treatment follow-up. So at 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, and 24 months, everything has to be documented. So now comes the masterline list, the MLL, which we maintained. So here, we can see the date of registration, starting from it. So here, the 4S symptom screening has to be documented. That is whether it is 4S positive, no, negative, or the 4S symptom screening is not done. What is the ICT status? Again, as we discussed initially, we have to write just the NA or IPD. Now, this is something which masterline list, which usually data manager does in the at the ERT center, and it is maintained soft copy, right? We maintain a soft copy on our system. That is masterline list ki. Hum log soft copy maintain karte hain. Jo data manager hai, wo hamare jo hai white card se information uthate hain. So we must understand if the information is not documented correctly in the white card, the masterline list will go wrong. Agar white card mein information nahi hai ya galat hai, to masterline list kabhi bani nahi sakti. Wo theek nahi ho sakti, right? Agar wahan pe white card mein hamare paas information correct hai, to hamari masterline list bhi theek hogi. So here we have to write the IPT status accordingly and then TB treatment status accordingly. Now, this is important, that is HIV-TB monthly report. We must understand, hum jo bhi recording yahan pe jo monthly report hum month ke end mein isko bhar ke ya phir agle mahine mein usually hum log kya karte hain, next month mein hum initial ke 5 days mein hum isko compile karte hain and then we send it to NACO, right? So yahan pe jo ye monthly report hai isi ke basis pe jo hai sare RT center ka compile hoke state ke paas hai, state jo hai compile karke national level pe bhejta hai aur national level ye sari compile karke ek data create karta hai aur ek scenario banata hai ki what is a scenario of HIV-TB or any other thing jo hamare monthly reports jate hain, okay, as per national level. To agar hamari jo recording hai wo galat hogi to hamari reporting bhi galat hogi aur agar ye reporting hamari galat hui to national level pe jo hai hamara jo data hai wo theek nahi aayega, राइट तो और अगर वो डेटा हमारा अगर गड़बड़ हुआ तो हमारे पॉलिसीज और डिसीजंस जो है वो गड़बड़ हो जाएंगे. तो मतलब आपके एक छोटे से रिकॉर्डिंग और रिपोर्टिंग से एक बड़ी पॉलिसी जो है नेशनल लेवल की जो है अफेक्ट हो सकती है. सो हियर वी सी दैट वी हैव टू राइट कंप्लीटली द रिपोर्टिंग ऑन इंटेंसिफाइड केस फाइंडिंग, द नंबर ऑफ पीएलएच आईवी अटेंडिंग एआरटी, देन उनमें से हमने कितनों को फोर स्क्रीनिंग किया, देन उसमें से हमारे कितने प्रिजम्प्टिव केसेस थे और हमने कितने जो है उनको टीबी डायग्नोज हुआ, राइट? तो ये वाली चीजें जो है सारी की सारी एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी डॉक्यूमेंटेड वेरी क्लियरली एंड वेरी प्रिसाइसली. एंड देन दिस इज 4.C.6 इज के आउट ऑफ अबव दैट इज द नंबर ऑफ पीएलएचआईवी विद प्रेजम्प्टिव टीबी टेस्टेड फॉर टीबी, द नंबर ऑफ पीएलएचआईवी डायग्नोज्ड एज हैविंग टीबी और वहां पे उसका बाइफर्केशन वी हैव टू गिव, राइट? Again, this is a continuation of the monthly report. So everything has to be completed and documented, right? So now, TB treatment outcome report. Again, in addition to HIV-TB monthly report prepared by RT center, the district TB center will generate a TB outcome report through NITRD for patients initiated on daily ATD at the RT center. And this report will be sent to ART centers. And ART center will be required to send this report along with the MPR. Now, this is the drug logistics. Now, this is, we have to maintain all the drug logistics in the drug stock register separately. And this is the ARV dispensing register. So, to be used for dispensing ATD drugs. So, here in this column, that is which says adult, others, we have to specify the ATD drugs, right? And here in the OI drug dispensing register, in this column, the dispensation of IPT, if we are dispensing, then that has to be registered over here. Now, this is the RNTCP revised referral form for treatment. So, in case patient on ATT is transferred out to any other ART center, RNTCP referral or transfer out form also needs to be sent along with ART transfer out form. So, with this, we end our presentation. I hope you have had good understanding on it by now.
So I'll thank Dr. Vandana for such an excellent presentation. And are there any questions that anybody would like to ask in the house? We would be happy if you would ask questions. See, what happens is recording and reporting is not a sort of in our habit. During our years of clinical practice, we really have not been taught much about recording and reporting. But ye sirf ek aadat ki baat hai. Agar ek bari aadat mein aa jaye to isme koi extra time nahi lagta. Bahut zyada extra time nahi lagta. Agar aapko mareez dekhne mein 10 minute lagte hain to recording mein shayad 2 hi minute aur lagenge, lekin wo 2 minute bahut precious hote hain for feedbacks. Number 1. ऊपर से हमें जो भी हम पेशेंट केयर एक्टिविटी करते हैं उसका रिकॉर्ड इसलिए भी रखना जरूरी होता है कि मेंटेनिंग द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ सर्विस. आज इस चेयर पे आप बैठे हैं, कल कोई और बैठा है, परसों कोई और बैठा है, तो वी शुड नो व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टू द पेशेंट बिफोर वी सॉ हिम ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर डे, इसलिए भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होता है. थर्ड चीज जो इंपॉर्टेंट है जो हमने देखा रिकॉर्डिंग एंड रिपोर्टिंग में, हमारी एक टेंडेंसी है कि हम कॉलम्स को या जो भी हमारे वो होते हैं स्पेसेस होते हैं उनको स्किप कर देते हैं. कुछ भर दिया कुछ छोड़ दिया, कुछ भर दिया कुछ छोड़ दिया. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. जब आप रिकॉर्डिंग कर रहे होते हो तो आपको जितने भी कॉलम होते हैं सब भरने होते हैं. उसमें जो इंफॉर्मेशन है वो आपको ठीक से भरनी है. और छोटी सी चीज है, एग्जाम्पल हाइट. पेशेंट की हाइट नहीं है, छोड़ दिया. क्यों छोड़ दिया? आप हाइट लीजिए, उसकी हाइट भरिए, उससे हाइट पूछ लीजिए. मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल नो व्हाट देयर हाइट इज. हमें ये जो हैबिट है ना हमारी कॉलम्स खाली छोड़ने की, वो ठीक नहीं है. उससे क्या होता है कि हमने काम भी किया लेकिन हम 2 सेकंड और एक्स्ट्रा डालते तो रिकॉर्डिंग पूरी होती, लेकिन हमारे सेंटर्स की रिकॉर्डिंग इनकम्प्लीट है. सो इट इज जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ हैबिट एंड थोड़ा सा मेटिकुलस होना चाहिए कि हमें सारे कॉलम्स भरने हैं. मैं फिर से एक बार हाउस से पूछूंगी, क्या कोई आंसर, कोई क्वेश्चन, कुछ ऐसी चीज जो आप चाहेंगे? So I'll start summarizing. Well, as you have seen in this presentation, हमारे पास अब कुछ नए printed formats हैं. Printed formats हैं patient visit register के, जो community care coordinator रखते हैं. उसमें already अब 4S positive और 4S negative का column छप के आया है. तो जब तक आपके पास नया register नहीं है, आप पुराने वालों में stamp लगाते रहेंगे. जब नया register आ जाएगा तो उसमें छपा हुआ है 4S positive, 4S negative, उस column को use करेंगे. हमारे जो वाइट कार्ड्स हैं, जो हम ART वाइट कार्ड्स हैं, वो HIV-TB रिकॉर्डिंग में क्रिटिकल हैं 2 तरीके से. एक तो वो क्रिटिकल है IPT के लिए. अगर आपने INH प्रोफाइल एक्सेस पेशेंट को ग्रीन बुक में एडवाइस कर दी लेकिन आपने वाइट कार्ड में नहीं करी तो क्या होगा? नेक्स्ट टाइम जब वो आएगा आपको पता ही नहीं चलेगा इसको IPT स्टार्ट हो गई है. और आप क्या करोगे? IPT के ऑर्डर्स देने, आप ऑर्डर्स देने भूल जाओगे, फार्मासिस्ट दवाई देनी भूल जाएगा और IPT इंटरप्ट हो जाएगी. तो इट इज वाइटल कि आप रिकॉर्ड करें वाइट कार्ड के पीछे कि इस पेशेंट को IPT चालू हुई है. जिस दिन चालू हुई है उस दिन IPT आई लिखें, फॉर IPT इनिशिएटेड. उसके बाद IPT 6 मंथ पे IPT कंप्लीटेड, ये लिखना क्रिटिकल है. नहीं तो हमारी पेशेंट केयर ह्यूजली सफर करेगी. हमने बहुत पेशेंट्स देखे हैं जिन्होंने IPT 1 महीने खाया, 2 महीने खाया, तीसरी बार कोई लिखना भूल गया तो उन्होंने वो बिना IPT के घर चले गए. ना डॉक्टर को याद, ना फार्मासिस्ट को याद, ना मरीज को याद. ठीक है. सो इट इज अ क्रिटिकल इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट यू हैव टू नोट इन द वाइट कार्ड. द सेकंड क्रिटिकल पार्ट इज कि अगर उसको एक्टिव टीबी है तो सामने जो स्पेस है फॉर टीबी डिटेल्स वो थोड़ा सा रिवाइज हुआ है. उसमें अब एपिसोड्स ऑफ टीबी के लिए जगह है. जैसे यूजुअली क्या होता था, एक स्पेस होती थी, एक से ज्यादा एपिसोड हो गए तो कोई लिखने की जगह ही नहीं रहती थी वाइट कार्ड में. सो नाउ यू हैव एन ऑप्शन ऑफ फर्स्ट एपिसोड ऑफ टीबी, सेकेंड एपिसोड ऑफ टीबी, थर्ड एपिसोड ऑफ टीबी, एंड यू कैन रिकॉर्ड द डिटेल्स. एक जो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट बात डॉक्टर वंदना ने बताई, प्लीज रिमेंबर प्लूरल टीबी पल्मोनरी टीबी नहीं होती. प्लूरल टीबी एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी टीबी होती है. अगर किसी को प्लूरल एफ्यूजन है तो उसको आप EPTB लेबल करेंगे. और एक और बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट बात है कि जो RNTCP का लैब फॉर्म है वो कॉमन है. चाहे आपको CBNAT कराना हो, चाहे स्मियर कराना हो, चाहे आपको कल्चर कराना हो, चाहे LPA कराना हो, फॉर्म एक ही है. बस उस फॉर्म को भर के आपको टिक करना है कि हमें क्या चाहिए. और HIV-TB के केसेस में जब हम डायग्नोसिस कर रहे होते हैं सस्पेक्ट्स का तो हम CBNAT ही टिक करते हैं, और जब फॉलो अप करते हैं तो हम स्पूटम स्मियर टिक करते हैं. फॉर्म सेम रहेगा लेकिन हम क्या कर रहे हैं, किसके लिए क्या कर रहे हैं, वो हमें टिक करना पड़ेगा. नंबर 1. नंबर 2, अगर आप उसमें पेशेंट का फोन नंबर नहीं लिखोगे तो हो सकता है आपके RNTCP वाले आपको वापस भेज दें.
उसका रीजन ये है कि अगर पेशेंट पॉजिटिव आता है तो ये आरएनटीसीपी के स्टाफ की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि वो उसे फोन करके ट्रेस करे. अगर आप मरीज का फोन नंबर नहीं प्रोवाइड कर रहे तो दे आर वेल विद इन द राइट टू से कि आप ये इंफॉर्मेशन कंप्लीट करके लाइए, अगर कल ये पॉजिटिव आया तो हम कहाँ ढूंढते रहेंगे. वो अपनी जिम्मेदारी निभा रहा है, इसलिए आपसे फोन नंबर लिखने के लिए इतना स्ट्रिक्ट है, लैंडमार्क लिखने के लिए इतना स्ट्रिक्ट है, एड्रेस लिखने के लिए इतना स्ट्रिक्ट है. अच्छा, और जो मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट चीज जो मुझे लगता है, आज भी आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम हमें आज भी एच आई वी लाइन लिस्ट और एच आई वी टीबी रजिस्टर के बीच में डिफरेंस नहीं पता. एच आई वी लाइन लिस्ट होती है फॉर सस्पेक्ट्स और प्रिजम्प्टिव टीबी केसेस जो 4S पॉजिटिव है, जिनको हमें ये लगता है कि इनको अब और हमें टीबी की जांच के लिए आगे भेजना है. तो एच आई वी टीबी लाइन लिस्ट में जो एंट्री होती है, जिससे पहले मरीज जांच के लिए जाता है उससे पहले एंट्री होती है. ये नहीं कि जब वो जांच उच करा के आ गया तो फिर वही लाइन लिस्ट का मतलब ये होता है कि जब हमने एक बारी किसी को टीबी सस्पेक्ट किया, हमने उसको सीबीनेट और एक्सरे का फॉर्म बना के दिया, तो हमने उसका नाम एक जगह लिख लिया कि किसी वजह से ये वापस नहीं आता, किसी वजह से इसकी रिपोर्ट नहीं मिलती, तो ऐसा ना हो कि एक टीबी का पेशेंट हमारे हाथ से निकल जाए और वो मॉर्टेलिटी हो जाए. उसका ये मतलब नहीं होता कि जब वो रिपोर्ट्स लेके वापस आ जाए तो उसमें लिख लो, वो मतलब बिल्कुल नहीं होता. लाइन लिस्ट होती है ट्रैकिंग के लिए कि जो हमारे पास एक बार आ गया, हमने जिसको सस्पेक्ट कर लिया, उसका हमारे पास ट्रैक रहे जब तक कि वो डायग्नोस्ड या अनडायग्नोस्ड एस टी बी ना हो. तो इसका सेकंड मतलब क्या है कि फर्स्ट डे आप एच आई वी लाइन लिस्ट भरेंगे, फिर आप उसको रिपोर्ट्स के लिए भेजेंगे, जब रिपोर्ट्स वापस आएंगी तो फिर उस एच आई वी टीबी लाइन लिस्ट का कॉलम अपडेट करेंगे, उस मरीज की रो को अपडेट करेंगे, और जब फाइनली डॉक्टर एआरटी सेंटर के ये बता देंगे कि इसको टीबी है कि नहीं है, जब एटीटी स्टार्ट हुई या नहीं, तो आप उसको तीसरी बार अपडेट करेंगे. तो एच आई वी टीबी लाइन लिस्ट हैज टू बी अपडेटेड. और जो एच आई वी टीबी लाइन लिस्ट में आ गया एज टीबी केस, जो एंड तक जिसकी अपडेट हो गई, वो बंदा, वो पेशेंट आ जाएगा अब आपके एच आई वी टीबी रजिस्टर. एच आई वी टीबी रजिस्टर सिर्फ उन लोगों के लिए है जिनको हम मानते हैं कि इनको टीबी है और जिनको टीबी का इलाज चाहिए. या तो वो हमारे लाइन लिस्ट से आएंगे या वो ऑलरेडी टीबी का इलाज खाते हुए पहले से एआरटी सेंटर आएंगे. तो ये दो कैटेगरी के लोग होते हैं एच आई वी टीबी रजिस्टर में. और इसके अलावा मैं यही कहूंगी कि अब नए फॉर्मेट्स आ रहे हैं, जब भी आपके पास नए फॉर्मेट्स आ जाएं, अपडेटेड फॉर्मेट्स आ जाएं, तो प्लीज न्यू एंड अपडेटेड फॉर्मेट्स लें एंड प्लीज डू नॉट इग्नोर रिपोर्टिंग एंड रिकॉर्डिंग. आई थिंक इट्स टाइम टू पुट अप द
poll
एंड वी विल आस्क डॉक्टर वंदना टू गिव द करेक्ट आंसर्स आल्सो टू देम. यू वुड लाइक टू से समथिंग?
Smoking, alcohol, they are not asking questions.
See, so Dr. Ananya has brought up a very important point. You see, there is a column for diabetes, there is a column for smoking, there is a column for alcoholism, but we just skip them.
So you're going to
asking the patient about them, we just go ahead and skip them. Why do we skip columns? Why do we keep up often complete? The patient is in front of her. Just ask him about these things. Skip columns. Actually not कि भाई जो हमारे पास इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं है हम नहीं भरेंगे. रिपोर्टिंग एंड रिकॉर्डिंग का मतलब होता है जो इंफॉर्मेशन मांगी गई है उसको आप गैदर करके फॉर्म में डालेंगे. ओके, सो यू हैव टू एक्चुअली कैप्चर दैट इंफॉर्मेशन, गेट दैट इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कैप्चर इट. इट्स नॉट कि जो हमारा मन आएगा वो हम भरेंगे या जो हमें पता है वो कॉलम्स हम भर देंगे. जिनमें हमें जरा मरीज से दो चार बात और करनी पड़ेगी वो हम नहीं भरेंगे. इट डजंट हैपन लाइक दैट. सो प्लीज बी कंप्लीट इन योर रिपोर्टिंग एंड रिकॉर्डिंग.
We're just waiting people to fill the poll. So once they're completing a little bit of poll, we will discuss these questions. The first question says that recording of HIV-TB data at AIT center is done only in register and line list. So, and there is no online data is to be maintained. So, यहाँ पे the online data is maintained in NITRD ID, if we remember, right? So, the statement is false. So, whosoever is giving the false answer is correct. So, now the second question is that HIV-TB line list is maintained by whom? So, we are very happy to see everybody has ticked out it. Staff nurse. The right answer is staff nurse. The third question says that status of IPT and CBNAT results are to be entered in patient's green book only. So now, what do you think? It has to be a patient green book only? No. The IPT status and CBNAT results are also to be entered in white card. We have seen the columns. So now, this statement is false. So, jisne true jawab diya hai, wo samajh jaye ki kahan pe gadbad hai. This is not true. Green book or white card, dono mein hum CBNAT result aur IPT ke status ka column bharte hain, usko record karte hain.
So, thank you very much. Thank you very much again, Dr. Vandana Dabla, for such a great talk. I thank Dr. Ananya. I thank Ajit for being the support, Mr. Ajit for supporting us today. Any other questions, you are welcome to ask us on email, on chat. One-to-one puchoge to zyada achha rahega. Aapki query se shayad auron ki bhi koi problem solve hoegi. But with these final comments, we have put up the poll for feedback. Feedback deke. We would like to sign off.